Good afternoon, dear participants. Thank you for your participation in the meeting. It is indeed a great pleasure to be with all of you on the 11th day of our online refresher course in chemistry, organized by UGC HRDC, Gujarat University, Ahmedabad. First of all, I would like to introduce Dr. Dilip V. Vasava, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Gujarat University, Ahmedabad. Sir did his postgraduate in chemistry from Veer Narmad, South Gujarat University in the year 2000 and received his doctorate degree in polymer chemistry from the same VMS Gujarat University in the year 2012. He has qualified Gujarat State Eligibility Test from Maharaja Saijirao University of Baroda in chemical science in the year 2019. Sir has 20 years of experience in teaching and training. He also worked as an assistant professor in St. Xavier's College, Gujarat. He has published 16 research papers and 2 books and also has filed 6 patents. Dr. Vasava is working as a reviewer in a collection of journals. Some of them are ACS Omega, American Chemical Society USA, Research on Chemical Intermediates Springer, Molecular Biotechnology, Springer, etc. On behalf of the Organizing Committee and Department of Chemistry, UGC HRDC, Gujarat University, and on my personal behalf, I welcome Dr. Dilip Vasava sir to this meeting. May I call upon Dr. Dilip Vasava sir to deliver his talk on virtual room, Department of Chemistry, Ahmedabad, and self-introduction. Over to you, Dr. Vasava sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Dr. Rekha, for your nice introduction.
Thank you, sir.
So far, every day we are meeting online, and whenever we are keeping the refresher course, we are taking the opportunity to visit the chemistry department. But right now, we are meeting online, so it is not possible to visit the physically to our department. So that is why we have kept the virtual tour of the chemistry of the department. So I thanks to Dr. Jagdish Joshi, Director, HRDC Gujarat University, and Dr. Miani and Dr. C.G. Brahmbhatt sir for giving me an opportunity to be a coordinator of this course. And today, on behalf of the Chemistry Department, Gujarat University, I will take you to my university and my department. So just I am sharing my screen to show some of the aspect of Chemistry Department, Gujarat University. So my screen is visible to everyone. Is it so?
Yes, sir. Visible, sir. Visible.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. So welcome to the Department of Chemistry, Gujarat University. Here we will go to the Department of Chemistry to see what are the things and what are we dealing with in the department. So once you will come to the Gujarat, the main city of the Gujarat is Ahmedabad. That is the very old city and very famous city. And in that Ahmedabad, this Gujarat University is established in 1949, and this is the oldest university in the Gujarat. Now this is the main building, that is the administrative building of the university. Now if you go 500 meter away from this main building, you will see the two-story building, that is the Department of Chemistry building. Now this is having the ground floor and first floor. So in the ground floor, if you start looking the department on the ground floor, left hand side, it is the departmental store. Next to that, there is a organic chemistry lab. Next to that, it is the one research lab and three classrooms. In the center, just the gate is visible. So notice board and restrooms are there. On the right hand side, the analytical lab and inorganic lab is there. Now from this center, if you go inside this gate, you will go to the first floor, and on the left hand side, if you go from the center, you will find the teacher's room. So all the teachers are given the separate room in the department and adjacent to the office. Next to that is the computer room and physical chemistry
sir
laboratory.
Tamaro voice clear nathi avto.
Okay,
na clear a jave ji.
Voice is not clear.
It's clear sir.
So we reached up to physical chemistry laboratory. If you go next to that, there is the HOD room and the library. On the right hand side, the smart classroom is there and two research labs are accommodate. If you go to the second floor, there is again one auditorium is there having the 180 capacity room. So front side there is a very good garden, and back side the two new buildings are coming up that I will show you. So this is how the building is. Now this department was established just after the establishing the university. After 10 years around, it was established in 1958. This department, chemistry department, is recognized as a center of excellence in supramolecules and nanomaterials by the UGC Gujcost, the Department of Science and Technology, Gandhinagar, Gujarat, DST FIST, and UGC Special Assistant Program, DRS Level 3. So this is the recognition awarded by the different funding agencies to the department. Now the vision is, a vision of this chemistry department is to provide the quality education. Not only that, but to encourage the use of technology for all-round development of the students, teachers, and associates. It is also committed to the integrity and professionalism, and lifelong learning is provided in this department, and that is the vision of this department. The mission of the department is to generate the think tank to provide the society and the world. That is the main focus of the department through the different activities, research, and learning process. Now the chemistry department is offering the master degree specialized in the organic, inorganic, physical, and analytical chemistry. These four branches are provided in the department, and of course MPhil is also provided in chemistry in the department, but in the new education policy, the MPhil degree is now removed, and Gujarat University has accepted the new education policy from this year itself, so MPhil course is removed. along with that, the PhD program is also running in the department. Now, we are only 9 faculties and the total intake is 600 around. So this is the glimpse of the intake in the MSc. So in MSc 1, 177 students are accommodated in semester 1 and semester 2. And from semester 3 onwards, they are distributed according to the merits in different 4 branches. So right now, analytical is having the 45 students, inorganic is having 26 students, organic is having 80 students, and physical is having 26 students. So all the 177 students are distributed in the 4 branches. Along with that, the special self-finance program is also run by the Department of Chemistry, that is the MSc Organic HPP program, that is the self-finance program. And that program is having the 95 students in MSc with specialized organic. And MPhil students are varies from 5 to 10. And at a time, you will able to find around 40 students in the department for the PhD program. The faculty, as I have shared, that we are having only 9 faculties in the department, but working with the good bondings. So here, the department head and professor is Professor V.K. Jain. He is having the specialization in inorganic chemistry. The research area is to design and synthesis and characterize of the new functionalized supramolecules, chemosensor derived from the calixopyrroles and calix from resorcinerins, oxacalixerin, azacalixerin, and thiacalixerin. He is having the highest teaching experience in the department, and that is of the 29 years. And rest of the data are given here. He is having the 2 books, more than 85 publications, and 89 programs are attended, and 4 collaborations are in his credit. The next professor is Dr. P.S. Srivastav. Recently, you have heard the pre-recorded lecture delivered by Professor Pranav Srivastav. He is having the specialization in analytical chemistry, having the research interest in quantitative bioanalysis using HPLC, LC-MS, and SFC, pharmaceutical analysis, nanomaterials, and biosensor. He is the one of the professor having the highest number of publication in the department and as well as in the entire university. And recently the data was published. In that, it was said the highest citation in the Gujarat was in his credit. So he is having the 229 plus publication, and 115 programs are attended with the different collaborations. Another professor is Dr. Hitesh D. Patel. He is having the specialization in organic chemistry, and the research area is the synthetic organic chemistry, green chemistry, chiral synthesis, computational chemistry, ligand, and the drug design. He is also having the 22 years of experience in the department in the entire university. He is the only person having the 4 patent granted and 15 patents are filed, and these 4 patents are granted this year itself. 12 books and plus 93 publications are in his credit, and rest of the data is visible to you, having the 47 plus programs attended and having the 10 national and international collaboration in his credit. Another professor is the Dr. M. M. Maisuria, sir. He is having the specialization in thermodynamics and metal complexes studies. Area of research is the thermodynamic study of pure and multi-component liquid mixture and metal complexes, having the 29 years experience and 14 publications in his credit. Dr. Harjinder Kaur is the assistant professor in Department of Chemistry and having the organic chemistry in as a specialized. Area of research is the hybrid nanomaterials for the heterogeneous catalysis and polymeric resin. She is having the 22 years of experience in the department and another institute, having the 30 plus publication and one book in her credit, along with the 33 paper presented and 9 programs are attended so far. Next assistant professor is Dr. H.M. Parekh sir. He is a right now participant in the refresher course. So one of the participant is the Dr. H.M. Parekh sir, having the specialization in inorganic chemistry. He is the only person who has done the postdoctorate fellowship in the South Africa for 3 years, having the 14 years experience and 26 plus publication and many more programs are attended so far. You are familiar with this person. He is a Dr. Dilip Vasava, myself, having the organic chemistry as a specialized, and the research interest is the synthetic high performance and biodegradable polymers, nanomaterials, nanocomposites, green chemistry, medicinal chemistry, and the organic synthesis. Having the different, I am having the 23 years of experience at the school level as well as the college level and department level. In my credit, I am having the 17 plus publications and 2 books, and more than 80 papers are presented, and the 45 programs are so far attended. I have filed 6 patents last year. She is Dr. Divya Mishra. She is also participant of the online refresher course in your group, and she is assistant professor having the pharmaceutical chemistry as a specialized. Area of research is the supramolecular chemistry, nanochemistry, and material science. She is having the 4-year teaching experience and 8 plus publication in her credits, and 5 programs are attended. Dr. Jayesh Maru, he's an assistant professor and he has net qualified recently, specialized in the organic chemistry. He is also one of the participant in the refresher course along with you. He is having the research interest in organic synthesis and method development for organic synthesis, having the 5 years teaching experience and 4 publication, 4 plus publication is there in his credit, and 18 plus programs are attended so far. So this is all about the all the 9 faculties and the brief introduction about them. Now these are the instrumental facility available with the chemistry department, that is the GCMS, DAC, then the electrochemical impedance analyzer, XRD, then the FTIR, DTA, fluorescence spectrophotometer, spectrophotometer, polarizing microscope, UV visible spectrophotometer, and ion chromatograph. So these instruments are there in the department. These instruments are handled by the PhD scholars, so it is given responsibility to deal with the instrument, and they are learning, and they are research scholars are operating all the instruments. Now these are the regular laboratories for the MSc students. So this is the organic laboratory, because the mass is more than 130 students in the organic chemistry. So morning and evening it is functioning. Then these are the laboratories for the analytical chemistry, inorganic chemistry and physical chemistry. So there is a laboratory having the capacity of 50 to 60 students, and it is joined with the lab assistant room and preparation room and teacher's room. That is the common facility in all the four labs. We are having the dedicated computer lab for the MSc students, because we are having the dissertation, industrial training, etc. in the semester 4. So students are utilizing during those days, and every day it is open for all the MSc students. This is the library having 10,000 plus books available, hard copy, and 50,000 plus e-resources are available in the main library. But we are having the departmental library separately for the reading as well as for the referring the books. These are the just sign of the peak of the smart classroom. This is the AC classroom. So we are having the two smart classroom and the auditorium. And very soon all the classrooms are going to convert into the smart classroom, having all the technological facility in the smart classroom. These are the regular classroom. So we are having three regular classroom with the normal facility. This is the auditorium hall having the 180 capacity. It is on the top floor. And that is all the also the smart classroom. We are having the meeting room, and right now it is the like online meetings are going on, but whenever physical presence is there, normally professors are meeting here. And right now I am sitting in this room, and I am delivering this lecture from this room, meeting room. This is the central store for all the four laboratories. This is the peak of the office where two clerks are working, and two pupils are there in the office. Now, department is organizing the get together occasionally for the teaching and non-teaching families. So all these kids are belongs to the teaching and non-teaching families. So during the festivals, we are calling them and we are celebrating with them. Next to this building, main building, chemistry building, next there is a red building, that is the analytical building also. And this contain around the 15 PhD research laboratories. So all the PhD scholars are working in this laboratory, and that is dedicatedly for the PhD program. So it contains the ground floor and first floor, and all the instrument facility is there in this building, and laboratories are also there. Now, very recently, Honorable VC has given a new building for the Department of Chemistry. So if you just look at this plan, where this is the 400 capacity auditorium is there, then the welcoming room and the director room is there, one instrument facility room is there. And that will accommodate around four instruments. Then the first floor. So this is the first floor having the laboratories, all the corner, that blue color is visible. All these are the laboratories. and all these are the SE laboratories with the modern facilities. And here there is a teacher's room. The laboratories are spacious, that is around 1200 square foot area is there, so in which around 20 to 25 students can able to work in one each laboratory. Same way, second floor is there having the laboratories, dedicated laboratories for the PhD students. And this is about to complete whatever plan I have mentioned. So this is the building, it is about to ready, and I think we will shift by the Diwali. So all the PhD students will go to this building, and all the faculties will remain there, and this old building will remain for the MSc students. So you are not able to come right now, but in future you visit this department and building. Now department is organizing various workshop and seminars and conferences. So last year we have organized the state level competition, as well as the international conference was organized in the month of September, that is the NM7. So every year more or less 3 to 4 seminars or workshop or conferences are organized by our departments. So I have taken the data from the 2015 onwards. Now students are awarded the fellowship every year. Few students are getting the fellowship like a UGC, RGNF, BSR fellowship, DST sub fellowship, RGNF, Maulana Azad National Fellowship, DST Inspire Fellowship students are getting. And last year, RA were Research Associates Fellowship were awarded. Of course, JRF is also there in the department. These are the main recent departmental projects, that is the projects on the supramolecules and the nanomaterials funded by the UGC SEP. 70 lakh rupees were awarded. Then the fund for the improvement of the infrastructure in science and technology, that is also funded by the FIST, DST FIST, New Delhi, 85 lakh were awarded. And the another project were there, that includes the nuclear science, and awarded the 26.27 lakh rupees. That was the awarded after 2015. These are the faculty projects, individual faculty project, and Professor Vikajan was having the three projects, and Professor H.M. Parekh was having the startup grant. H.D. Patel is having the Gujkos project, and also Dr. H.K. Dr. Kaur Madam was also having the departmental and the project, individual project. These are the patents granted by the agency, and that was credited to Dr. H.D. Patel sir. So two are already published and two patents are granted. Three patents are granted, and another 15 patents are filed by his group. Now the placement record is very good, and due to the industrial hub, Gujarat is the industrial hub, and due to that we are getting the good placement. So every year around 80 to 90 students are placed in the different industries in the range of 2 to 3 lakh packages after the MSc. We are having the 5 MOUs with the different institute and industries. Now students are taking interest to clear the GSET or NET or GATE, GRE, etc. So right now I don't have that much data, but recently last year 10 students has cleared the GSET, that is the Gujarat State Eligibility Test for the professor. 5 students has cleared the NET, and these are the current students. I am not talking about the ex students. Those who were in the semester 4, semester 4 or semester 3, they have cleared this test. GET is cleared by the 4 students, and IELTS for the foreign English language, that is also cleared, and 1 student has cleared the GRE. Now you are welcome to the Gujarat, and there is a reason to visit the Gujarat, and specifically Ahmedabad. You will find the very famous Sabarmati Ashram in Ahmedabad, then the Mahatma Mandir located in the Gandhinagar, just 30 kilometers away from our university, and national and international conferences are taking place here in the Mahatma Mandir next to the statue of the Mahatma Gandhi. Then in Ahmedabad itself, there is a biggest lake, that is the Kankaria Lake, and another facilities are available. This is recently developed, that is the riverfront. Sabarmati River is there, so riverfront is very famous in Ahmedabad nowadays, so people are visiting. And the Siddi Syed Net is very famous, and the Moscow is there in Ahmedabad. So these are the attraction of Ahmedabad Gandhinagar, but there are different places are available in the Gujarat, and you can visit. And this is the highest people are attracting, that is the Statue of Unity, that is the tallest statue in the world, near the Narmada Dam, located in the Kevadia, and it is just 200 kilometer away from the Ahmedabad and 100 kilometer away from the Baroda. So this is the reason to visit the Gujarat University and Gujarat. So I request and I welcome you to visit the Department of Chemistry, Gujarat University, and the Gujarat. So thank you so much for attending this session. It is just a glimpse of the Department of Chemistry and the Gujarat.